she was about this high when Stu and some of the rest of them were talking. And now she's grown to be a young lady. And we'd like to have her do a couple songs for you.
Been left questions come from. As soon as I learn, I'll chase them away. Cause I've had a taste of tenderness, simple and true. It drives away the doubting and draws me into your open arms. Your love has taken hold and I can't fight it. I'm giving it to your open arms. They pull me to you. They wrap your love around me. I'll rest in your open arms. Open arms. Your love is taking hold and I can't fight it. I'm giving it to your open arms. They pull me to you. They wrap your love around me. I'll rest in your open, open arms. Your love is taking hold and I can't fight it. I'm giving it to your open arms. They pull me to you. They wrap your love around me. I'll rest in your open arms.
Okay, I'd like to say something. We've got a guy here tonight who is a fantastic fan of gospel music. And one of his favorite things is steel guitar picking, playing, I guess you call it. And so, Ori Krupp, we dedicate this song to you.
Thank you.
say a few words tonight. So, Ed, why don't you come up and you're not going to embarrass us or anything, are you?
No.
Have you enjoyed this tonight? I promise you, I'm not going to sing. But as a representative of the Knox Brothers, the Dale Krupp family, gospel music interests here in the Valley, we wanted to give you something to say thanks for the good years of good music. Well, I don't know how to do this, because if I tip it over to show you this cake, it'll all be on the stage, and I will defeat the purpose by which I have come to show you. So why don't you open it up and maybe have it setting on the front or something so people can see it. But we wanted to give them something just to show our appreciation to them as, and I'll use this Russian term, comrades in the gospel music world. I think it's a Christian term, and if you agree, give them a hand, will you? Says, go ahead and read it.
It says, the Good Shepherd's Quartet, thanks for the years.
And there's a beautiful guitar on there, and the notes and the music and everything. And Ross IGA did a very fine job on it.
Thank you.
Come, here she comes. Come on, Carrie.
Singers and you name it. And those old hymns, they'll just last forever. And they have meant so much to us over the years that we'd like to share this one with you. Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound.
I'm
We sang song after song after song about heaven and about what that was going to be like to spend forever around the throne and with each other. And now we have already experienced one of us is already there. And Willard knows by experience what that's like. We still have to accept that by faith. Willard's already there. We'd like to share with you a song that means an awful lot to us. And Willard sang it very well. He sang about that one of these days, all these troubles and trials would be over. And one of these days, he would be in heaven with his Father. Would you play that song?
Show me the way. Then when Jesus came and conquered all of my sin, gave me hope and peace where my burden had been. I'm gonna be with my newfound friend one of these days. Supplying the life of your way. Jesus is the answer to your troubled soul. Give him your heart and then you'll know. You're going to a land where you'll never grow old one of these days.
His friend. after he left us, we didn't know whether the Lord wanted us to continue or not. And I think probably a week or two went by. And one fact, the afternoon of Willard's funeral, Leanne had, and the boys had asked all the quartet to come and spend some time with them. And as the evening progressed, as the day progressed, we were all children of the King. And we began to realize that yes, Willard did leave us, but he also graduated. And he graduated to the highest level that any human being could ever be, and that was in the presence of Jesus. And as we realized that, we just began to sing. And I remember through our grief and tears and sorrow with the family and everybody there and the quartet, Mark picked up his guitar and I think Lonnie grabbed his. We just started playing and singing. We probably sang for 2 or 3 hours, just songs that we'd sung over the years together. I believe that God used that as an ointment to start the healing process, to realize once again that life is short, it's just a vapor. The Bible says it's just like a blade of grass. It withers and dies and is blown away. And some of us think that we have years and years and years to live the way we're living and to carry on with what we're doing. But we were reminded once again that life is so short and there are no guarantees. And we'd like to have Mark come up and play that song that kind of helped us through that. In fact, while Willard was still with us, we had sung that. And the person who had written that song had gone through a tragedy of his own where he had lost almost everything. He had been through the Depression. He was a very wealthy man. And he'd just gone through the Depression and lost almost everything. And he had sent his wife and family to Europe on a trip just to get them away so he could just kind of get his thoughts together. And they were on a ship. And tragic struck. I don't know if there was a storm or whatever that came up, but the ship went down and there was an accident. And he lost, I believe it was all of his daughters. And he got a telegram from the other side that said, his wife sent a telegram and said, you know, we've lost our family. And tragedy after tragedy, this gentleman was experienced. But there was a key. He was a child of God. So he boarded the next ship out, and he told the captain, he said, when you get to the spot where the ship went down, where I lost part of my family, he says, I'd like you to let me know. Early the next morning, about 2 o'clock that morning, the purser came and knocked on his door and said, sir, the captain has informed me that this is the spot where that ship went down. With that, the gentleman went up on deck. Realizing the tragedy that had struck him, but also realizing that he had Jesus Christ as his Savior to kind of undergird him and comfort him. Sometimes it's so hard to think why. We want to ask why. We want to question God, and sometimes we even become bitter and want to strike out against God because we want to blame him for taking our loved ones. But this gentleman realized that he was a child of God and that everything was in his hands. And he penned the words, it is well with my soul. And we've probably been singing that song probably about 2-3 years before Willard went home to be with the Lord. And what a comfort that was to know as we gathered around, and the deep hurt and the sorrow that we felt, we were still able to sing and to feel the comfort of Jesus Christ and simply say, it is well with my soul.
It
that time, we felt that the Lord wanted us to continue singing, and so we did. Lonnie took Willer's place singing the bass part, and we went on. And I believe that the Lord was grooming Lon to take his place, because before that time, Lonnie had stood back there and played bass guitar for years. And he would sing with us, even though he didn't have a mic. He knew every song by heart. He knew his dad's part. I remember him telling me, says, "Emerson, I want to keep going. This is so hard to try to fill my dad's shoes. But he's done a great job. And I'm glad, Lonnie, that you stuck in there." Do you want to sing a song? We'd like to have Lonnie and Rob sing a song that kind of helped them through these troubled times. And if you want to share something about that, go ahead.
I don't know what I would have done without the quartet to help us through the time when our dad passed away. It was hard. I mean, anytime you lose somebody that you love, it's hard. But I guess now that I can stand back and now that time has helped heal some of the hurt, I can stand back and I can say that, like the closing of this group, like the ending of the Good Shepherd's Quartet, that it's not an ending, it's just a beginning. Just like my dad's death, it's not an ending, it's just a new beginning. Because he's starting eternity. And it kind of makes me mad because he started before us. But I know without a shadow of a doubt that I will see him again. And the song that we're going to sing, it's called All I Need to Say. And it's a song by Michael W. Smith. And it's just a song for my dad. And it says some of the things that we feel when we lose somebody we love.
Say goodbyes, never quite.
Singing about Jesus Christ, and you don't have him in your heart and life, you're missing out on the greatest, and I mean that, the greatest thing in life. There is nothing better than that. There is nothing better than giving your heart and your life to Jesus Christ. If we would not have had Christ as our Savior to help us through the grief and the sorrow that we experience, and you have too. All of you probably have experienced grief, and there's just something about having Jesus as a personal friend to help you through those times. And if there's anything that we can leave with you tonight, if you forget everything that we've ever said or sung, I mean, even if you forget Joe and his funnies and his southern accent, and all that, I hope that you remember one thing, because this is one thing that we have tried to convey to everybody that we've sung to over the years, is that God loves you more than anything else in the world. And there is nothing, I mean nothing, that he wouldn't do for you. And the reason why some of us don't get blessed is because we're up there with our clenched hand. We haven't learned to open it and receive what Jesus has for us. I challenge you tonight, open your hand. Let Jesus take it. Let him take you by the hand. Lead you through the rest of your life. And I'll guarantee you, without a shadow of a doubt, that we will see you over on the other side. We'd like to close by singing a song that talks about how thousands and thousands of us, just like us here, and millions, will stand around God's throne once and for all. We can say, we shall see Jesus.
We shall see Jesus just as he is.
Once on a hillside,
showed mercy to the one who had healed them. Yet Jesus loved them as he suffered and died.
Thanks for being here. Thanks for making this a special night for us. And I hope it's been a special night for you. And again, I hope this is not the last time that we see you again. And I hope that if we never see you on this earth again, that we will be able to meet you in heaven when we meet on the other side with all of our loved ones who've gone on before, and most of all, with Jesus Christ. We'd like to close with a word of prayer and ask God's blessing as we leave. One of the things that I did not mention and I don't think was covered was that Jerry did mention that he is going to become involved, or he is involved right now in starting a new church in the Brownsville area. And that's So there's other things that have happened, like Lonnie's becoming more involved in becoming a doctor. Robbie, our piano player, has started working with another younger group, a more contemporary sound. And I'd just like to become more involved in my home church for a while. I've been kind of a stranger for about 18 years. And so it's going to be kind of nice to kind of get back home again and fellowship with our little family there and to work and serve the Lord there. So we have found over the past year that God has been starting to call us and move us in other directions. And we're excited about that. It's hard to be able to say goodbye and to start a new era. But one thing that we have found is that God's people must be ready for change, because it's very easy sometimes to get too comfortable. And I believe sometimes God uses certain areas of life to help us to hire ground to other places. And I believe that God has used the Good Shepherd's Quartet as a stepping stone for 49 different people and training them for other services. So with that, we'd just like to say good night. God bless you, and we'd like to close with prayer. After prayer, we're going to go out in the back, and we'd like to just shake hands and hug you or whatever and say goodbye to as many people as we can. If you have to leave, we'll understand. But again, we love you. God bless you. Let's pray. Father God, it's just been great to be here and to share your love and your hope and your salvation with all these people. It's neat to be a part of a family who you are our Father. And Father, we just pray now as we leave this place, as we go to our different occupations, our different service for you, we pray that you will bless our lives, help us to grow in you, and to always remember that you love us more than anything else. Help us to be willing to open our hand to you and to let you take us wherever you lead. Dismiss us with your blessing. Thanks again, God. Most of all, just thank you for being so good. In Jesus' name, amen. You're dismissed.